This question belongs to computer organization subject and was asked in GATE CSE 2020. So the question states, consider the following data part diagram. So here we have data part diagram. Now it is saying, consider an instruction R0, R1 plus R2. So R1 plus R2 is stored in R0. The following steps are used to execute it over a given data path. Assume that PCB's program counter is incremented appropriately. The subscript R and W indicate read and write operations respectively. Okay, so here we have the instructions. Which of the following is the correct order of execution of above steps? The steps are R2 read, temp1 read, ALU add, temp2 write, R1 read, temp1 write, program counter read, memory address register write, MEM write, memory read, temp2 read, R0 write, MDR, memory data register read, and instruction register write. Okay, so here you can see that this third instruction followed by a fifth instruction. The third followed by fifth is basically your instruction fetch cycle. Okay, micro operations, and can be elaborated as follows. So for first, what will happen is that we will read the contented program counter and store it in memory address register. Right. Okay, so this is done by third instructions. Then in the memory data register, what we will write is the content at the memory location R, and then we will also increment our program counter. So program counter is incremented successfully. We have stored the value at program counter, we have read it and stored into a memory address register, and the value of at that memory location is read at from memory address register. This location data is read and stored into memory data register, and program counter is implemented. Okay, then we have a fifth instruction. So what it does is that it then reads the memory data register, it reads it and store it into a instruction register write. So we will store our instruction from our memory to our instruction register. So this is third, these three are third instruction, this is fifth instruction. So first of all we will have three, then we will have five. Now after instruction fetch, we will have our execute cycle to perform the operations. Now you observe the figure and it will be very easy to identify which steps are following which. Okay, so you can easily see what are the steps. See here, here we are performing an ALU add operation and we are writing in temp2 and we have a temporary register. So before this we need to fill this temporary register, so we can't have 1 as of now. Now can we have 2 as of now? Yes, we can have 2. So 2 is clearly stating that we will move the content of R1 register. So we will read R1 and we will move it into temp1. Okay, to some temporary register, and it is clear that before performing the ALU operation, temp1 should be there. So hence second will occur after 5. So here we will have second. So third is done, second is done, 5 is done. Now what we have? Now see. Now we will perform the ALU operation. Okay. And can take the second operand directly from R2. And the figure clearly shows that we need to put the result of ALU back into temp2. So here we will have temp1. We have stored this value. Second one we can take directly from our register. And then we will store the result in temp2. So temp2, this step will occur after we have done our first step, because first the addition will be performed and then only we will have a result in temp2. So now we will perform the addition. So what will happen is that we will take our content of temp1 and then we will perform the read operation with R2 read. So we will read R2, we will read temp1 read, and we will perform the addition operation. And we will store this in temp2 write. Okay, so first operation will be done. Now we will have 1. So this is our instruction fetch. This is our, these both are combinedly instruction fetch. Now here we will perform the ALU operation. Here we will store the content in temp1. Here we will perform the ALU operation. Now what we have? Now we have our result in temp2. So we will read the content of temp2 and store it in our register R0. Similarly here you can see temp2 is stored to a bus. From here it will come to R0. So what we have? We have temp2 value is stored in our register R0. So now after this we will have our instruction 4. What is this? This is storing. Okay, so first we have instruction fetch, then we have this execute operations, and then we have memory write back operation. Okay, so the steps are 3, 5, 2, 1, 4. So 35214. So correct answer is option C.